vlog. So I didn't do a proper introduction, but I'm currently in Portugal, Lisbon, Portugal, waiting for my connecting flight to Praia, Cape Verde. But just thought I'd give a little explanation for why I'm here and where I'm going to. So I'm going to be going to Cape Verde for my Atlantis fellowship program, where I will be shadowing physicians in Praia, Cape Verde. I'm really excited, but I'm currently in Lisbon right now. It's about 7 o'clock, and I'm gonna be getting on my connecting flight around 9 something. But I'm learning Portuguese little by little. So yeah. So I'm heading to the flight now. Exiting now up this ramp to see how we do it. I don't know if I'm gonna do this though.
This is very cool. Very, very cool.
So just lock your wheels and it stays.
Interesting.
So I'm currently alone in the apartment slash house slash room. So I figured I'd just give you guys a little tour of what like our room looks like.
Starting from our front door, you walk in, you see our dining table. Then you have our kitchen. It's my reflection in the wall. Kitchen. This stove is nice. And you have our microwave, which is nice, and oven, our own fridge, our living room, and you guys have got to see the view. The view is so amazing. The room's a little dirty, but get the gist. You can see the whole island pretty nice from up here. It kind of reminds me of Nigeria a lot, to be honest with you. And over here to this window, see some more views of our neighbors, people that are working. There's a little glare in the window, but you can see the mountains in the background, especially that way. See some mountains down there. But yeah, so that's the view you get from the living room. And I'm gonna take you guys to the bathroom.
This is my suite mate's bathroom.
There's two bathrooms. There's two bathrooms and there's two bedrooms. Shower. So this is my room. Let me turn the light on. Little desk, closet, two beds.
And this is my bathroom,
which is pretty nice. There's no views in these rooms, which sucks, but it's okay. And this is my suite mate's room. And that's pretty much it for our place. It's nice. It's our little humble abode. Yeah, that's everything for you.
So now I'm gonna show you guys what's in my Atlantis bag, because my amazing site manager was able to get me a bag. Well, all of us have our bags. Was able to get me a bag, my Atlantis bag, with some nice stuff in it. So I'm gonna show you guys what's inside.
So first things first, when you open the bag, you'll see, this is open already. I can already open this stuff already, but Yeah, this is the phone she got us just so we can reach her. The SIM and stuff. My phone pretty much has like internet, like with Wi-Fi, but this is good just for calling, like if my phone doesn't have internet. We also have our journal, so we're able to write about our day, which is nice. This is a power bank, because this is honestly amazing, because one issue I have whenever I travel is that my phone always seems to die, that, you know, from vlogging all day. So this power bank is so clutch. So yeah, cool. Oh, this is my name tag for the hospital that I'm gonna be shadowing at. I actually asked her for this. I'm not sure if it's gonna come in everyone's bag, but mine came with this. We got a little pen in there as well. That's everything in the bag, but everything in the bag is pretty clutch, to be honest. Like, they're all things you're gonna definitely use on this trip. I'm gonna have videos for days. About 8 p.m. right now, and she's having dinner. We didn't go out for dinner tonight, so having a little cup noodles for dinner, as you can see in the microwave, with some mango juice. And while I stay up to edit these videos I have. We start our rotations, our shadow rotations tomorrow. So I gotta be up tomorrow by like 6 a.m. to eat breakfast, and then we gotta be at the hospital by 8 a.m. So I'm excited. Hi, good morning. Today is day 3 and I look chalky. But anyway, we're heading to breakfast right now. Today's the first day of fellowship. Have my water, my white coat, and my name tag, but we're heading to breakfast right now. I can't vlog the whole day because I'm in the hospital, but I'll come back and tell you guys how my day went. But yes. I think it's good. Hey guys, so currently in my white coat. I'm actually at the hospital right now. I'm actually in the bathroom. Thought I'd give you guys a quick update. But right now we're actually in general medicine / internal medicine. Currently we're just waiting. Most of the doctors don't speak English, so we're actually just waiting here to wait. We're waiting to see a patient. Really, we've been here for a couple hours now, and so yeah, that's the update. You see my name tag.
Hey guys, so I decided that I'm actually going to be reading excerpt from my journal entry from every day we spend at the hospital, so you guys can get like an idea of like what we saw. So I'm gonna go ahead and just read some parts of day one. So week one, day one, Chelsea and I are currently in internal / general medicine, and we were able to see a 52-year-old male stroke victim who had lost feeling in his right side due to a hemorrhage lesion on the left side of his brain. As a result, he lost feeling and movement in his right jaw and lower right lip. The stroke is believed to have been caused from his hypertension and excessive alcoholism. We were only able to see one patient today, and so we spent most of the time asking the other physicians about their healthcare system and medical school system.
Alrighty, so we just came back from our fellowship shadowing today, and I'm currently walking to the ice cream place. I'm gonna meet up with my friend Hanny there. Oh my gosh, it's windy.
Needed to ice.
Hey guys, so we're actually waiting for our driver to come get us. We're waiting to go to dinner right now. So we're all outside waiting. Day 2 shadowing, and I'm currently dressed. I did not go out to breakfast today because I decided to get more sleep, and I'm having breakfast here in my room. Just a pretty, what's the word, natural breakfast, like mangoes with mango juice, and then I ate a plum. So I still had the house in a couple minutes, but wanted to just check in for the day. I might do like every day, like day 1, day 2, day 3, like every day of fellowship. We'll see. But yeah.
Alrighty, so we're all done with day 2. We're all today done with day 2. Today was a great day. We did a lot of stuff. Saw many patients, ate some cake. Can't go wrong with cake, you know.
So day 2, as I said, we saw many patients. One of the patients we saw was a 14-year-old congenital HIV patient who contracted HIV from birth. And so she came in because she had a outbreak on her skin that covered her face all the way down to her toes and her throat. And the doctor's suspicion was that it was a fungal infection, since she does have a suppressed immune system. Infections are common. We also saw an 80-year-old woman who was admitted for cardiac arrest, but her pulse ox was doing okay, so the doctor believed that she was recovering. Then we went to the emergency room and we were able to see an elderly woman who came in for pain of her wrist, her jaw, and fingers, and it was determined that she had osteoarthritis. We were also able to see another congenital HIV patient around the age of 8 years old. She came in because she had difficulty breathing and a cough, and we were actually able to listen to her lungs.
And I could actually hear turbulence.
So it was a great day, it was awesome.
Yeah. We out today.
So we're heading to a lunch cooking class with everybody, and we're gonna meet our site manager there. But yeah, it's nice weather.
To the museum before we head to get the food for our cooking class today.
Cape Verde was colonized by the Portuguese during the 500.
Coming at you with day 3, and today is like a beach day, but it's gonna be a fun day today at the hospital. I'm excited, and we out.
So today was one of the most interesting and exciting days of shadowing at general medicine. We were able to see so many different patients. We first began the day with going on rounds with the nurses. There weren't any new patients, but a few did leave, which is good. We found out from Dr. Soraya that there was actually a death this morning. It was a 92-year-old man who had Alzheimer's, which led to him being on bed rest and contracting pneumonia. It's ironic because when walking to the hospital this morning, we noticed a woman was crying, and Chelsea was saying that today would be interesting. I replied to her saying that somebody must have died, and that's exactly what happened. We found out that the hospital has a 5% death rate, which is actually pretty great. Only 3 patients had died in the month of June. To give you an idea of the hospital size, the patient that died this morning was a 606th patient this year. Dr. Soraya was filling out the death certificate for the national census and for the registry of death. We were also able to see a critically ill male between the ages of 80 and 90. Who had suffered a stroke. He was unresponsive and had labored breathing. We were able to hear his lungs, and I could hear how tired he sounded. The patient also had atrial fibrillation, or AFib. A new patient came in and was also another HIV patient. We discovered he was 43 years old, and the month before found out that he was HIV positive. Then 5 days later, discovered that he had tuberculosis. He was admitted because he had dehydration and tachycardia, which is a rapid heart rate. He was jaundiced and also had labored breathing. They believe that the medication from the tuberculosis was attacking his liver. His tongue was also white due to oral candidiasis, which is fungal infection. He also had pneumonia in his right lung. We had to wear really thick masks, and we're able to listen to his lungs as well. And the whole experience was just so interesting to me, because usually in the American healthcare system, we're not really able to come that close in contact with individuals who have communicable diseases such as tuberculosis and things like that. And so it was a great experience for me. Dr. Soraya then showed us the sonogram from a patient with a history of stroke who was 5 weeks pregnant. Due to her her health, the pregnancy is high risk and she will have to terminate it. The patient will be getting a salpingectomy, which is a removal of the fallopian tubes. She will now never be able to conceive again naturally.
All right, day three is over with. I look shiny, boy. Damn. But we're leaving the hospital now, as you can see, and we are about to head back to the hotel so we can get ready to go to the beach.
Oh, sorry.
Say hi. So we're heading to the beach now. We're walking there. It's not even like around the corner to walk, but we're walking there. Pray for me.
So we've come to the Praia sign. The way to get to the ferry, I believe. Or, oh no, this is the way to get to the bridge. They're building the bridge here. Get out the way. That's the way to get to the hotel they're building over there. It's pictures right there.
Day four, heading to the hospital.
So fourth and last day in general medicine. After doing rounds with the nurses again, Chelsea and I were able to go to the cardiac unit, and we actually spent most of it shadowing a cardiologist. As he walked into the room, he was seeing a patient with AFib, which is when the atrial chamber of the heart is unable to properly contract, which causes excess blood in the atrium and makes the patient more prone to blood clots, which can lead to strokes. We then went next door and saw another patient who had AFib. We were able to listen to the heartbeat of the two patients who had AFib, and then Chelsea and I were also able to listen to each other's heartbeats in order to compare. Dr. Luis Diaz was very great at explaining things to us and always made sure to educate us on each topic so that we were not confused or lost. We were able to see the patient's heart on the echocardiogram using the probe. We could see all four chambers and also saw that her mitral valve was not fully opening, which caused an irregular heartbeat. The patient had stenosis of the mitral valve, making it difficult for the blood to pass through. After that, Dr. Soraya came back and got us, and we were able to see other departments of the hospital, such as dialysis, HIV and hepatitis B treatment, hematology, oncology, and telemedicine. Upon getting back to general medicine, we ended the day with a big party, and there was a bunch of food, and it was so much fun.
Last day in general medicine, and ended it with a little party, so it was nice.
but I'm now heading back to my room.
Thank you all so much for watching. Make sure you stay tuned for part 2 and 3 of this Atlantis/Cape Verde vlog. There's so many more outings, excursions, and shadowing in more parts of the hospital, including pediatrics. But in the meantime, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you enjoyed it. And make sure you stay on the lookout for part 2.